In 1911, Harry Karanzev came to the United States from his homeland of Macedonia.
He wanted to follow his brother to America to pursue his dream of running his own business and then helping his parents and siblings to have a better life in Greek-influenced Macedonia.
In 1913, Harry opened up a candy store on the corner of 14th Street and St. Louis Avenue. In a flourishing business district, Harry slowly became the king of St. Louis confectionaries. One day while cleaning out the wooden platform in the store window, Harry found a dirty bent sign that was simply inscribed with the word Crown. This is how they got the name Crown Candy. Harry wanted to make sure that everyone knew that his goods were handmade and he created more than just candy and ice cream, so he added kitchen to make it Crown Candy Kitchen. Harry asked his second cousin Pete Jugaloff to be his partner in business because of his carpentry skills and general handyman abilities. Pete built the wooden booths, candy cases, and soda fountains that are all still used today.
In the beginning, Harry, Pete, and Alini made only three flavors of ice cream, vanilla, chocolate, and strawberry, using 300 pounds of ice and rock salt daily and the exhausting hand crank method of a manufacturer. Ice cream cones with two dips sold for 5 cents, sundaes with chocolate syrup sold for 10 cents. Eventually, they added chocolate ice cream sodas using carbonated water, phosphates in 6 different flavors, and their signature malt. German candy makers had come to St. Louis to ply their trade, and as with the manufacture of ice cream, Harry and Pete were invited to watch these masters make their candy. Eventually, their observations taught them how to develop the product that became Crown Candy. Do you think you can tell? Did they get you to train your heroes for ghosts? From those same German confectioners, the Karanzevs purchased candy molds for Easter bunnies and St. Nicholas.
Shortly after, the Karanzevs began to occupy the living quarters above the store. They were working 16 hours a day, 7 days a week. Harry and Pete had a great relationship with Coca-Cola. This led to the collection of Coke products we can still see in the store today.
After returning from World War II, Harry's son George took over the family business. With Harry and Pete getting older, George would always hope that he too would have a son to take over the business. George was blessed with not one son, but three. Michael, Thomas, and Andrew were the next generation of Karanzevs to take over the business.
The oldest son, Mike, was the first of the new generation to take over the business.
When did Crown Candy start?
Crown Candy started in 1913. My grandpa opened it up, Harry.
All right, and when did you take over ownership of the store?
We took it over about 10 years ago from my father. So my brothers and I were the third generation.
George's second son, Thomas, was born in the living quarters upstairs from the store and worked there from the time he was 10. Thomas soon became the head cook in the kitchen. After high school, George's third son, Andy, attended a junior college, but quickly decided that Crown Candy was the place for him.
In 2002, there was a question about Crown Candy Kitchen on the nationally televised game show Jeopardy! The question, what is, if you can eat, drink 5 malts within a half hour, you get them free of charge, and a contestant actually got it right.
How did you get the idea for the Crown Candy Challenge?
Years ago with my father, the guys would come in from the neighborhood and they thought they could always drink 5 malts trying to impress the women. So he bet them that, you know, you can drink 5 malts in a half an hour. So this dates back way back when, and just the tradition just kept on going, and now we get a lot of college kids and high school kids come down and try to drink 5 malts. And we have a little plaque over here where we have, I guess, about 12 names. So
12 people, and one guy did 6, right?
Right, he was a professional eater.
Professional eater came in here and did 6.
What item is sold the most?
Candy-wise or ice cream? Ice cream is the malts. We sell a lot of malts. Chocolate banana malt, fresh banana malt, and candy we sell, Heavenly Hash is our big sell. We ship that all over the United States.
How much candy does the store produce a day?
It all depends. Like at Christmas time, you know, a couple hundred pounds. Easter time, you know, we go through 4,000 pounds of chocolate just for rabbits. We import like licorice comes from Australia, and then gummy bears comes from Germany. Mostly the gummy candies all imported.
What's your favorite item on the menu?
I like the chocolate malt and the chocolate sundae with crushed nuts.
What are all the types of candy you sell?
We sell all kinds of chocolate candy. We have peanut clusters, cashew clusters, pecan clusters, the heavenly hash, which is chocolate marshmallow pecans. We call it a turtle, a snapper, caramel chocolate pecans. And then we have all kinds of gummy candy. We don't make the gummy candy.
On December 25th, 1983, the space heater in the store's restroom malfunctioned and started a fire. Fortunately, the place was closed, but the back of the confectionery suffered the most damage. A portion of the original tin roof ceiling, some of the Coca-Cola memorabilia, one of the wooden booths, and a section of the back wall were all ruined by the fire. Put out the fire, don't look past
my shoulder. 1 month after the fire, on January 31st, 1984, Crown Candy Kitchen opened its doors again. Since the fire of 1984, Crown Candy has continued to build on its tradition of being one of America's most authentic candy kitchens and restaurants.